If you have already subscribed, then click the bell icon to get instant notifications when I put a new video up. Do it now. Yo guys, what's up? So first of all, I want to wish everyone a very happy new year. I hope your new year started with a bang, and I really hope that you guys do some really fantastic things in this new year. Before we get started with today's DIY, I just want to request everyone, if you're new to the channel, then please click on the subscribe button and subscribe to my channel. We do a lot of fun and simple art DIYs on this channel, and this year I'm planning some really interesting stuff. So please subscribe. And if you have already subscribed, then thank you and welcome back. All right, let's get started with today's DIY. Now, we all like to do up our spaces. And one of the things that we like to do is hang art on the walls. Now, to have a nice looking art piece, it either takes a lot of time or effort, or it's really expensive to make or buy. So I'm gonna teach you guys a really simple and easy method to create a really beautiful and modern looking art piece. And for that, you don't even need to paint it. We'll use a pendulum to create that art. And mind it, it's really inexpensive. Sounds interesting? Then get ready, it's time for some DIY. Why? Because I love it. All right, let's get started. So first we're going to make a contraption that will create our masterpiece or the art. So for that, I'm using this plastic container. As you can see, on top of this, I have made three markings. Along these markings, we will punch three holes so that we can tie thread and then suspend this or hang this to create our art. So to make the hole, I am going to use a thumb pin, and this is an eraser. So what I do is I place the eraser on one side of the plastic glass, and from the other side, I punch a hole. So let's get the plastic glass in. So here we have the plastic glass. I'll just flip it and place it over the eraser like this. And now I can very easily punch a hole without getting hurt. Right here. And we'll make another hole for the other marking. Okay, so you can see the holes are done. And now what I'm going to do is I am going to take a U-clip. Now I'll just open one of the ends like that, so it becomes a hook. And now you can easily hook this like this with the glass, and you can hang the glass easily. Now on the other side of the U-clip, I'm going to attach a string. So I've taken a nice long piece of string right here, about 2 feet long, and now I'm going to tie one of the ends. You can tie the string directly to the glass, but we are going to pour color in that. And what happens is sometimes when you want to change the color or you want to just change the container, it becomes a longer process if you tie another piece of string to the glass if you want to change it. With this mechanism, you can just hook another glass to the same contraption. All right, our hooks are ready. So you can see that I've attached the ends of the strings to these U-clips, and the other end of the strings we have to tie together in one knot so that we can suspend it from a height and then hang it to create our patterns. Okay, so this is done. All right, so let's attach the hooks to the glass. So you can see simply like that, I can just connect it. So again, we'll do the same thing. I'm going to place the eraser inside so that I don't poke my fingers with the thumbnail. I'll turn it around like this, and right in the middle, I'll punch a hole. So right here, we have a hole. Now, we need to make this hole slightly bigger. So what we'll do is we'll take a skewer and we will poke it like that and just push it in to make this hole slightly bigger. So there you go, the hole is ready. Okay, so you can see we have a nice big hole here. If you feel that the color is not pouring out or seeping out properly, then you can also make this hole bigger or wider. The next step is you have to push the skewer in, and when it is nice and tight, just take a marking and cut it, because this will also act like a stopper. All right, so with scissors, I am cutting it, making a small dent, and now I'll just break it. And there you go, we have a small stopper. Now let's attach this to the plastic glass and see. Yeah, works fine. So this way, now the paint won't pour out. And whenever you're ready, you can pull it out. So now our contraption is ready. This is our pendulum that will create patterns. So now we'll keep it aside and get our canvas and color ready. Now for the color, I'm using acrylic colors. You can use some nice bright shades. Now acrylics work best for this in my experience. You have to get a nice thick consistency. If the color is very dilute, then it will pour very fast. Your pattern will get very messy. And if it's too thick, then it will not pour out of the hole. So you have to get a nice consistency, not too dilute and not too thick. All right, so mix this well. Now to make the consistency of this color slightly thicker, I have this glue here. This is your regular glue. So I'm gonna mix this into our color solution, and this will make it nice and thick, and this actually helps it pour much better. So let's add this to our solution. Okay, so let's pour the glue in this. Now you have to keep in mind that you have to add the same amount of glue as you added water in the solution. There you go, I think that's enough. Now let's mix this. I don't know if you can tell on camera, but now the consistency has become nice and thick. Look at this, if I try and pour, we get a nice line and it doesn't drip so fast. Look at that. And this is what we need to create our patterns and our masterpiece. So yeah, the color is ready. Now we can pour this in our contraption or the pendulum. So let's give it a shot. So before we fill this up with color, I'm gonna suspend this. So now on this knot, I have attached another big U-clip, and I'm going to just hang it right here. So I have this frame where I usually attach my camera. So similarly, you guys can attach it to a fan or a frame like this, or on a stick, basically somewhere where you can just attach and suspend this so that this contraption basically moves like a pendulum. So there you go, this is ready. Now let's pour the color. As you can see, because of the stopper, the color is not coming out. So now I can just leave this. For my canvas, I'm using a nice thick chart paper. It's a nice flat gray because I am using a bright orange for my print. So I think this combination will look really nice. I'm excited, a little nervous too, but let's see. This will be fun. So let's remove the stopper and take a print. Here we go. Look at that. Nice clean lines. The paint is flowing really well. Couple of stops in the middle, but it's creating a beautiful pattern. As you guys can see, we had a little spill. That's fine. Wow, this looks really interesting. Look at that, how easily you can create this really cool, almost psychedelic kind of pattern. And the cool thing about this technique is that you can try different patterns. All you need to do is change the swing of the pendulum, and you can see you start getting different patterns. Look at this one. Like earlier, we got a more circular pattern. And this one is slightly wider with like a rectangular pattern in the middle. Looks pretty cool. So there you go, that's how you can create some modern looking art using a pendulum. I really hope you guys enjoyed watching this video and found this tutorial helpful. If you did, then please don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up. Like it, I would appreciate that. Also, share it with your friends and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. I'll keep reminding you until you subscribe. And then you can get your friends to subscribe. If you have already subscribed, then thank you. You can also subscribe to my blog channel, Robin the Hood, where I put up really interesting vlogs about my life and about my inspirations. So you can have a look at that too. Also in the comments below, please let me know if you have any ideas or your suggestions for any cool art techniques or DIY projects. I'll go through it, I'll connect with you, and maybe I can make a video around that. All right, that's the end of the video. I'll see you in my next one. Until then, like I always say, do good and be good. Peace.